हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू जियो डिक्टेटर। एज यू नो, इलेक्शन कमीशन हैज़ डिक्लेयर द डेट्स ऑफ इलेक्शन। पोलिंग विल टेक प्लेस इन 7 फेजेस सेम एज 2019। इलेक्शन प्रोसीजर विल स्टार्ट फ्रॉम 19th ऑफ अप्रैल टू जून 4। इट इज़ द लॉन्गेस्ट वोटिंग पीरियड सिंस 1951। काउंटिंग विल टेक प्लेस ऑन जून 4। द नंबर ऑफ वोटर्स इन 2019 वॉज 91 करोड़, बट इन 2024 इट इज अप्रॉक्सिमेटली 98 करोड़, विच इज अ 6% इंक्रीज फ्रॉम लास्ट इलेक्शन। आई डोंट नो हाउ मेनी ऑफ देम विल वोट, बट 98 करोड़ पीपल आर एलिजिबल टू वोट इन दिस इलेक्शन। इन 2019 बीजेपी वॉन 303 सीट, वाइल द एनडीए टोटल वॉज 353 from 543 Lok Sabha seats. This time, the aim of NDA is 400 plus seats. In 1984, after the assassination of Prime Minister Indira Gandhi, the elections were held immediately and Congress got 400 plus seats in Lok Sabha. This was the only time a party got many seats. Meanwhile, in 2024, if Congress loses its seats and get lower than 52 seats, then it will lose its leader of opposition title. In that case, regional parties will not take Congress seriously. It is a do or a die situation for Congress. Recently, new election commissioners Subir Sahu and Gyanesh Kumar has been appointed under panel led by Prime Minister Narendra Modi and Congress leader Adhir Ranjan Chaudhary. But there was absence of CJI Chandrachud to conduct the election fairly. Sukhbir Sahu is from Punjab and is former IAS officer. He has also served as a chairperson of National Highways Authority of India (NHAI). Meanwhile, Kumar has served as secretary in Ministry of Parliamentary Affairs. During his tenure in the Home Ministry, Kumar oversaw the abrogation of Article 370. The two vacancies in Election Commission had arisen after the retirement of Anup Chandra Pandey on February 14. And sudden resignation of Arun Goyal. For the first time in the Lok Sabha elections, people above 85 years or with disability will be able to vote from comfort of their home. The total number of senior citizens above 85 years is around 80 lakh. This video is about 2024 elections, so we will also include electoral bond issue in it. In 2018, central government notifies the electoral bond scheme. But a NGO named Association for Democratic Reforms lead petitioner moves to the Supreme Court challenging the scheme. On 15th February 2024, Supreme Court declares judgment and repealed the scheme by saying it violates the constitutional right to freedom of speech and expression as well as the right of information. So on March 4, SBI moves to Supreme Court seeking an extension of time till June 30. To disclose details of each electoral bond. But Supreme Court dismisses SBI's plea seeking extension. The State Bank of India on March 12 submitted the details of electoral bonds to the Election Commission of India after the Supreme Court ordered the bank to disclose the details. The Election Commission published the details shared by SBI on its official website on March 15. According to the data, BJP received funding over 6,000 crore via electoral bonds, while the TMC got 1,600 crore. The Congress received 1,400 crore through these bonds. It surprised me that a regional party has got more money than Congress. Now it's all up to you, which party you support or will vote. I will never influence you to vote a party. Stay healthy, stay safe, and comment your thoughts. Thank you.